Hello, it's Jang here from JANGBRiCKS.com with a look at a LEGO system set from 1999. This one came with 245 pieces and was called Space Simulation Station. This whole thing is supposed to represent a piece of a NASA astronaut training center. So you've got your high G training over here, although it is outdoors, it really should be indoors. You've got a little trainer craft here, which is small and looks like it would actually fly, even though I think it's supposed to represent just a re-entry module that would be just sitting there, but you can take it off and fly around with it if you would like. And then you've got a control center back here, a little tower for just kind of looking over everything, and on the back of that, that's got some stuff inside. Though one of these printed slopes is fairly common, one of them is not, so that's one nice thing about this set. I also like the top of it because it's transparent, with the transparent blue, and you've got this interesting looking thing, kind of a half of a disco ball. It's a chrome gold in color. Just a interesting looking piece, and you can angle that around different ways. Got a couple of antennae up here. You've got your PA system with the speakers on either side. And the thing looks pretty good from the front too. Down below, you get a couple of fuel bottles or gas bottles. I guess one would have fuel and one would have oxygen in it. It's interesting that they chose to go with a transparent piece in the middle so you can see inside of there. Okay, I think it kind of looks pretty cool, but the rest of this base is mostly open. All this space under here is open, so I guess you could put the little runabout, little land vehicle in there, use it as a garage, but you see it's just a whole lot of open space with these two base plates that are included here. One of them is a 16 by 32, one of them is just a 16 by 16. Let's look at this a little more closely. I think the real life analog of this would be just kind of a training module, just a cab section that would be for familiarizing astronauts with a simulated, actual set of controls where you could get in there and see what you would really see once you go into a real mission. Basically just a little simulator capsule, and that has a pretty nice, I want to open this up so you can see that console, that printed piece down in there. Nice multi-colored piece, and taking this off also allows you to get your single pilot in there a little bit more easily. But you notice the whole thing is designed to be removed, and it looks like it's got some exhaust coming out the back with this huge rocket motor or complex of rocket motors together. So I think this is trying to look like it would actually fly around, and what do you know, you can angle this whole thing up to launch it off. So I guess that's a good thing for a play feature. It doesn't necessarily go properly with the theme, the simulation theme, but I think it's okay. Nice that they've got the ladder that can be pulled back. Then you just get a bunch of tools, a full set of tools down here, plus one extra little thing, looks like a flashlight. These are all in the original dark gray, not the newer dark bluish gray, because it was 1999. This is my favorite part of the set over here, the big high G training centrifuge, because this is a seat. You can put a person in there, and you've got a counterweight over here which will actually swing out, and you've got a handle so you can easily spin this around. You can see that that both pieces on the ends swivel out. It's pretty appropriate. It's just looks like a fun little ride, a cool looking basic thing. It's simple, but I think it looks good. Not so much from the back, but still, it's nice that they put in the different colors with the transparent pieces and also these printed caution pieces. I think that this looks good and works well. The little ground vehicle is small and simple, but it looks pretty effective. Kind of looks like it's some sort of ATV, and it has a light bar on the back or roll bar. Also has a couple of clips for holding onto things. You see a small little fire extinguisher and also a radio. This thing is, it's cutesy and it's very Lego-y. I like this. It feels like more of a classic Lego design. Three minifigs here, all with distinctly different torso prints. You also get two different face prints, with these two being shared, even though they look fairly different with the different headgear. Obviously, this is the astronaut in training, and the other two are folks who are going to be support staff, or one of them might be project manager, staying up in the booth or something like that. You can decide who you want each to be. And there's what they look like from the back, relatively plain. Of course, you can bring the visor down on the astronaut as well. To me, overall, this is a pretty underwhelming set. I like the play feature of the centrifuge. The figures are fine for their day. They look pretty good. Otherwise, just kind of disappointing to me. It's plain. The little shuttlecraft thing is odd, awkward. This is fine for just a little runabout thing, but on the whole, just not a very satisfying building experience and not a whole lot of play value to this thing for its overall size. It's just really spread out. I feel like this the money that went into making these parts or that people had to pay for this set would have been better spent on something a little bit smaller and just more interesting. This was during a period in LEGO's history when they were doing really weird things and they were kind of going downhill at the time in every way. Thankfully, they recovered to start doing better stuff, and thankfully, all of these pieces are still useful today. So I will use this stuff to make stuff that I like better. Please share a quick comment covering what you think about this set, whether you agree or disagree with my opinion of it. And I'm going to keep getting more stuff and bringing you more reviews, so stay tuned. I'll be talking to you again soon.